What is going on, everyone? KM Dolph back yet again for the next exciting installment of Transport Fever. Now, guys, as you know, at the end of the last episode, as all sorts of things are happening here, Alcos that can that are running through here, our 3801 that we released at the end of the last episode is also making its presence known. Look at this. He just went through a gate. Well, these things happen. But look at him go. He looks brilliant. He's off to do the new mainline route that we created at the end of last episode, or during the case of last episode. And let's turn these dollary-do things off, because we don't like them. What are we going to get up to today? Let's do something exciting. Now, we've got new passenger lines set up for the main line, so that's all exciting and good. What we're going to do today is we are going to focus, and I know that most episodes I start off here, but we are going to start off today with $17 million in the bank. We are going to look at the David W. Freight Incorporated. It needs an overhaul, it needs to be bigger, it needs to be stronger, and therefore the trains that run on it need to be bigger and stronger as well. So we are going to look at bolstering, is that the right word to use? Beefing up, we're going to use the beef up. We're going to beef up the freight so that we can deliver more, so that we can get more sitting here, so that it's all going to be one massive goods conglomerate, and it's going to be awesome once that's all fixed. So guys, stay tuned, as that's what we're going to get into today, and we're going to get into it right after my intro. Okay, we're back from the intro, and I thought a bit of train spotting before we get into the David W. Freight Incorporated today. Little Alco that could, he's heading off to the Palm Springs, doing that little bit that he does. Meanwhile, a little Great Western number sitting at the gate. He's going, what's going on? Why am I being delayed? And it's all because of this big fella right here doing a whole bunch of 40 kilometres an hour. Breakneck pace that it is. Right, on to this. Now, this is going to require a lot of work, so what we're going to do is that's going to have to move and be revamped. That's going to have to be extended massively. So what we're going to do, let's hit the pause button so that we don't destroy everything in its path. All right, where's my good friend, the bulldozer? All that stuff's going to go and it's going to be horrible. Terrible stuff. You know what I probably should have done is I probably should have just made it longer. No, because I want to make more tracks. That's fine. All right, we need to get rid of that one. Unfortunately, you guys are going to lose out there. You're going to lose out there, and everyone's going to lose out everywhere. Cool. Right, we need a bigger one of these. We need to do the smoothings. Spend my money doing the smoothings. But it's all got to look nice and presentable for when it's all said and done. Cool. Now, straight into some sort of a train freight-based depot thing. I can't use that because that thing's terrible. It has to be a terminus. I want a terminus. I don't know what that is. But that's a flexible one. Why have I got flexibles? That's pretty cool. It's just a shame that it's not the flexible one that went. Ha 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 ha. I don't want to give away too much, but that's getting installed today as well, people. Cool. Let's have a quick look-see at that. That's a standard cargo station. Freight station terminal. That's what we need. So we need to fling that around there. We're going to need, I'm going to want like a dozen, like multiple tracks. I want, oh Jesus, no, I don't want that. I don't want that many tracks. I want length. 200 meters. You need to be longer than that. 400 meters. Well, you know, I mean, this could be slight overkill for anybody paying attention at home, but good God almighty, that's way too long. We don't need anything that ridiculous. Let's just go 400 metres for now, please. Why are you poking your butt end up in the air? It's a bit stupid, isn't it? Right, I need to come back down here because you need to connect up with the tracks there, Sunshine. This game is going to proceed to fight me every single step of its miserable little way. Right. I need you to stop doing that thing that you're doing. Right, when all else fails, get into some terrain modifications in that way that you do. Right, let's lower things up a little bit. Right, that should have worked. With a bit of luck. Maybe it didn't. Why are you... I don't like this. This is not... This is not the way I had envisaged this working at all. Right, so I can't get you there, but I can get you there. Wait. I had a snap. Come on. Snap. Snap for me. See, you work in theory. But the problem is I've got a lot of collisions and the effective terrain alignment, effective collision that comes along with it. So I'm going to have to... This is going to like use up a lot of my money. I'm not going to have much money left for this endeavor that I am endeavoring upon. Well, at least it works somewhat now. You can't complain to me anymore, can you? Right. How does that look from that end? I don't even know. Can I get around there without the game sort of going into some sort of dummy spit at me? Oh, here we go. Do it from this angle, Mr. Dolph. Okay. So, I can get effectively... No, I can't get that. Okay, you're not going to do it. You will if I get rid of that bit of road. So what I'll do is I'll get rid of that little bit of road. And I'll rebuild that road. Because that's what we do in Transport Fever. We knock down, we rebuild, and we do it all over again. Okay, so effectively, all of those lines add up. Which is great. And that's what we're going to go with. This is what we do. Only thing I have to do is get rid of the catenaries because I don't want the catenaries. Now that is obviously a little bit of a ridiculous length of a second street connection. Yes, you like that second street connection, don't you? Good, you're in. You're in. Love it. Now I need to put some road back in because I effectively deleted a lot of road to make this happen in that way that you do. Small country road, no. Medium country road, yes. Right, so I need you to go out to there, please, and do that thing that you do. Good. Now I'm going to have to figure out where to put this truck freight stop that I had, that I no longer have, because it's... I could effectively do that, but I would need to make... I wonder, can I make that work? I mean, I probably could. It's just a shame that you can't make it longer than that. If only you could. That'd be brilliant if you could do that. I mean, you could use that if you wanted to. What else have we got for options? Two cargo, three cargo. Well, poopery. Okay. Truck station with multiple cargo terminals. I'm just going to go with this one because this one actually looks pretty cool. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to stick it somewhere where it gets connection to everything. And then I'll be hunky-dory, hopefully. All right, I'll just... Yeah, you got access to everything. You're good. Okay, so you've now got access to international food bulk, international freight bulk, palm freight bulk, and the chewer food bulk. So that's good. You're getting food delivery, and you're getting international stone. We need to rename this to David W. Freight... I can't even spell Freight. Is it Freight EI? Can't remember. Freight Incorporated. David W. Freight Incorporated. Freight is spelt wrong. I can tell. Nah, it looked better the first time. Someone correct me in the comment section, please. I don't know how to spell because I'm apparently a bit silly in that way that I am. Okay. Now we've got to fix all these little Caspers up. And then we should be good. So that comes from the processing plant to David W. Freight Incorporated, which is fine. So you just need to be told to go somewhere. You need to go to a different platform is what you need to do. So why have you been re-nicknamed to David W. Freight Incorporated? I don't want you as David W. Freight Incorporated. You are just international goods bulk. There you go. You can go to that. And that should then work. The problem is that I've got to get you off of there and get you to come back into here like so. And then you need to do something similar. So you need to get off there. You need to come into here. And then you need to get off of there. And you need to come into here. Okay, so that's the food done. That is the food bulk done. The chewer food bulk is now done. International freight bulk needs to be fixed because you're not coming into there at all. You need to come into... But you need to come into a better station than that. So I'm going to get you to come into somewhere. Somewhere better. So, okay, that's one, that's two, that's three. I'll keep you on three. I need to fix up whatever freight line that was that's coming in there. The orange one. Where's the orange one? Chew a food bulk. Yes, you need to change platforms, please. I want you coming in on platform five. Five. That works. Three individual freight stops. Perfect. Good. Fixed. Fixed. The palm freight bulk. No, you're not fixed. You need to be fixed. You get out of there. You come into there. Good. You got your own line. You're happy. Stone bulk. You need to get off the David W's. And you need to get onto the drop-off point. That should effectively be it. I think I fixed it. So what should happen now effectively is this should be fixed. So this should start collecting stuff again at a rapid pace, which it is already starting to do, which is great. Keeps high production to upgrade in 5 months. Good. We want the upgrades. We want everything to start happening. And then what I get to do in turn is as life progresses, I will be able to make more and more stops for this along the way. I've got ideas for these two ones here to go up to the north side, up towards the yonder of the Jackson City, south side, etc., and beyond. There'll be two services running there, one to the furthest two and one to the closest two. So that will work quite comfortably. That one will still run the Palm Springs. These ones will still do their own business. And then these two here, I'll run them out to Villa and Alexandria and beyond because that's going to look amazing once it's done. Now, I only have $5 million left. I spent way too much money today. I want to keep that little diesel Alco thing, but I do want to fix up... I want to fix up the little... What was that? Something just went kaboom. Don't know what it was, but I'm certainly not complaining that it's there. Where's the thing that could? Where's my lines? How's my balances doing? Are my balances doing okay? Fort Southside main line's losing me a lot of money, but that's all right because the passengers haven't started picking up on the fact that that line's going to rule. International freight bulk is the current leader of everything, along with the international food bulk. Food bulk. Oh yeah, that's just the one that runs down to the bloody food processing plant and back, so that's easy. Fort Villa International's making me about a million and a half quid a year. And then I've got the Chewer food delivery, which is not making me any money. And the Keystone commuter, which is also not making me any money. Keystone commuter? Where's that? Oh, hello. Something's coming in. What's that? Ah, it's my 3830. You timed your arrival very well, although you have nothing on you. You're very empty there, my good sir. Why is it that you are so empty? Oh dear, you didn't pick up anything on your last round, did you? The good thing is, there's going to be at least 22 stone to take back. Whilst it's not overly impressive that you've done that, at least you'll have somewhere to go. Is the stone sitting on the right side? Yes, it is. I like it how it's just sitting nice and crisp there in the mountain like that. Look at that. Wonder if I can smooth that out. Let's quickly try and smooth that. Yes, that looks a bit better. Now it just looks like it's nice and cozy there in the mountain, rather than looking like it was forced. I swear it wasn't forced at all. None of this was forced. I let it do its own thing, I swear to God. Right, that's you fixed. That's you looking schmick. Now we can get rid of that. And this station is now way too long for anything to make sense. But it's good because as we grow, that will tend to get a lot bigger and it will be a lot better. I can store more stuff on it and it's going to look great. But yes, I agree, that station is way too big. Something's coming in. Who's that? Ah, it's my food train. Good. He's on the run. God. Jeez, I really overdid that station, didn't I? Good God almighty. Okay, cool. Here comes the food train doing its little business. It's going to have plenty of stuff to take back with it. Stone line's doing its thing. Everything's doing its thing. It's all happening. It's all working for the most part. So that's you know, that's always good. Little Alco that could come back. This will drop off a substantial amount of foods. Everyone's going to get foods, hopefully. Who's getting foods? Oh, there you go. See, Palm's getting some food for him to take back. That's good. That's very good. That's very nice of him. Good. That's all happening. That is all happening. And here comes a little Diesel Alco that could. He'll come in. He'll stop about halfway. They'll start loading that up, and he'll take off on his merry little way. And that will all be glorious in due course. I realise now that how much overkill that is, but I don't really care because it's going to be bigger, it's going to be better. As everything sort of takes off, it's going to be, in a word, glorious. So that's pretty much going to do it for today, I think. Look at this. He's got, there's a lot of foods there going to the fort, which is good because there's a couple of trucks that have come to pick some stuff up. Actually, let's quickly do this. Oh, hello, I just lost money. That's what that was. Can I get a bigger vehicle for freight yet? No. I've got a Studebaker. He takes food. And he goes no faster than the Opel Blitz. So, not really gaining anything out of that yet. I'm going to have to wait a little bit longer for some better trucks. But once I can get better trucks and upgrade roads and do all that sort of wonderful whatnot, it's all going to look great. Oh, that's what I wanted to do. I wanted to upgrade this little fella. I do want to upgrade him. We'll do that before we go. Let's do that now. Yeah. I kind of want that train to stay there. I don't exactly want to get rid of him. Replacement? Why do you not let me have that loco that I want? I do not understand these things that you do, dear game. Locos. Alright, let's scroll down and find ourselves something relatively something relatively good. That only does 55 k's an hour and doesn't pull much. There's a GWR, there's my American stuff, there's my 11 class, 32 kilometres an hour. You are not doing anything in a hurry. The OBB, 90 k's an hour. He pulls a little bit. You know what? We'll stick him on. We'll make him blue so we can make him a Thomas train. Because that's what we like to do. We do these things because we can. And then we need some wagons to transport food and construction materials at the very least. All right. Early boxcars. No, we need better boxcars than that, I think. I don't want that because that's not going to give me what I need. Boxcar. I don't want to do the naffies. I don't. No naffies. I want to avoid the naffies. But you do carry everything that I need you to carry, but I still don't want to use you. Grain, planks, plastic, food, crap. Nah. I need to go into the freight department, please. See, you're good for that because you will carry construction materials and food. You will not. I need something that will carry what I wanted to carry. Man, this is annoying. Why can't things happen in this game that I want them to? That only carries food. Wow. That'll be great for a long food train eventually. British tank. No. Early boxcars. You will carry food and you will carry construction materials. Alright, fine. I'm going with the early boxcars. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 times 7 is 35. 42, 49, something, something. Okay, just do that, please. Replace it. Cost me 3 million. Done. Paid for. Happening. It's all happening. Oh, he's coming to his little stop. Look at that. He's at the end of the line. Brilliant. And he's got... Oh, he's full. Good on him. All right. We're going to watch him take off like we did at the end of the last episode. So... Guys, what I will do is I will call this episode off for now. I've done enough fiddling around with the freights and whatnot. So, as this 3801 takes off, right on cue. Guys, thank you very much for watching today's episode. I know it was a bit of a stuff around with the freight side of things, but we'll get into some more stuff next episode. So, guys, thank you very much for watching. Make sure you leave a like, and I will see you for the next installment of Transport Fever. Take care, everyone.